Get on down with your bass up. Get on down. Listen to the sound. Come on.
Post Riot
Radio.
Nick.
The ghost. The ghost himself.
And the ghost with those men.
Nicky!
Ladies and gentlemen, what is up? Welcome to Ghost Riot Radio. My name is Nick Noble, and I'm your host here each and every Sunday on Ghost Riot Radio, the 18 and over podcast designed for free-thinking adults just like yourself, currently being recorded in a semi-sunny Sarasota, Florida. As always, I'm going to do some quick shout-outs like onecollectiveclothing.com, doing quality 90s hip-hop, street-inspired tees, hats, and accessories for the kids of yesterday. That's onecollectiveclothing.com, as well as bigtroublemedia.com, doing graphic web design and print services. They design with an edge and an eye for what is dope. That's bigtroublemedia.com. Folks, if you are just now joining us every week on Ghost Riot Radio, I invite a few special people here to the Riot Bench to discuss whatever the hell we want to. And this week, I am fortunate enough to be joined by my homie, your friendly neighborhood Mad Dog. What is up, brother?
Catch me outside. How about that?
I was waiting. Yeah. Somebody was going to do it. I knew it. It's awesome. Folks, and since this weekend seemed like a very fitting time to do so, I've invited a few of my favorite women on this show today. To my left, I have Samantha Cipriani of Night Shift Wax Co. How are you, Sam?
I'm great. How are you?
Fantastic. Thank you. And I also have the lovely Gisselle Tirse.
Hello.
It's fucking up her last name so bad.
You said it.
I was trying to American
it. You like, got it, though. It sounded great.
I was like, oh, it's Gisselle Tirse. No, it's Tirse, and get it right, peeps. She is also an incredible artist that I have met recently, and they're both lovely friends of mine, so I invited them to hang out with us today. We're talking women's rights on this show today. We're also going to play some music, and, you know, it may be a little, I don't know, it's not that weird. Fuck it, women love death metal too, but we're playing death metal today too, so it's going to be an awesome combination of two really interesting things for us today. So since today's topic is women's rights, we do want to hear from you. I will be opening up the phone lines. We've got the band Nomadic joining us on Skype today, so there will be an interview with them in the first half of the show, but during the second half, we do want to hear from you. So if you're watching and you happen to have an opinion about women's rights, or were part of the march yesterday, or any of those things, or you just want to like shout out like the coolest woman you know, we want to hear from you. So make sure you hit us up. It's 813-343-4798, and I'll put that number out on the table during the second half. I'm going to shut these guys down real quick because we need to talk about this band today. Today, oh, by the way, this is episode 14. Not too bad. We're doing okay. Yeah, not bad. Episode 14 here. Yay. So, if you are just turning into Ghost Riot Radio for the first time, during each episode, I try to feature a new musical artist of the week. If you or your band would like to be featured on an upcoming episode, you can email me at info@ghostriotradio or ghostriotradio@gmail.com. I need you to send me your three best tracks with a bio of yourself or your band and any contact info you want me to air, and I'll do my best to get you on the next available episode. Folks, this week is pretty crazy. We get to introduce to you a band called Nomadic. They are a death metal band from Tampa Bay, Florida that formed in late 2015. They released their debut EP entitled Horror in April of last year and then released their single called The Crooked Man in October. Nomadic began touring that very next month. They went on two headliner tours, one with Bradenton local band Unto Moria, I hope I got that right, in September of 2016, and a Nomadic-only headliner in October. They're actually leaving for tour with Lourdes from Sarasota, Florida, from February 3rd to February 18th, and a headliner tour with Aluka from Maryland, what's up, MD, from March 3rd till March 17th, which is booked by Wavelength Booking Agency. Nomadic has plans to release two records in this year, so we're pretty stoked for that. This first song, as well as all of the tracks I play today, are available on iTunes, Google Play, Spotify, YouTube, and more. Folks, this is Nomadic with The Count.
The
So fucking awesome. Folks, if you're just now tuning in, that was the band Nomadic with a track called The Count. We're super stoked to have these guys here. And now we also get to interview them today. So folks, joining us live via Skype, we have two members of today's band. Please join me in welcoming Mr. James Lewis and Nick Zayas of the band Nomadic. What is up, dudes?
Hello, hello.
How you doing?
Good, good, thanks. Good.
That shit got me hyped.
Yeah, it was awesome. I've been rocking hard for like 3 days since they sent me that stuff. Dudes, super awesome. Thanks for joining us. Do us a favor and go ahead and introduce yourselves. Unfortunately, we don't have video for you guys today, so there's no way you'll be able to see them. But I'll post some pictures and stuff so you'll be able to figure it out. Maybe I'll do like arrows to who Nick and James are. We'll figure it out.
I'm the cute one.
Oh. Perfect. So go ahead and introduce yourselves and tell us a little bit about who you are and your role in the band.
I am Nick and I play guitar.
Hello, mortals.
My name's James. I do vocals, and I also am a engineer and producer at Forerunner Recordings and the founder.
Oh, fantastic. That's awesome. So tell us how you guys met and how the band got together.
Well, the band got together in an early formation back in like 2012. Mm-hmm. The drummer and I have been jamming ever since then. It just kind of fell into place that we met James through two separate bands at the time that were selling tickets to each other for different shows.
Nice.
Yeah. Yeah, we met in 2014, and they had a vocalist who had legal curfew issues, and they needed a fill-in for a show with Rings of Saturn as Blood Runs Black in November 2014, so I played that show, and then we were like, being in a band sucks, so we broke up for like 7 months, and then we came back July 2015, and we kept the name Nomadic, which they had, just because, you know, we kind of cheated. We wanted to keep the following.
Yeah.
And it didn't really matter because we broke up again for 6 months.
Oh, shit.
and we had our first show back as this rendition of Nomadic, keeping the name, but with all new songs, all new aesthetic in February 2016.
Oh, wow. Wow, that's awesome. Well, are we losing you? Are you still there?
Hello.
Oh, good. Huh? Loud enough. All right, good. All right, so cool. So you mentioned that you've been Nomadic now off and on for a little while. Nomadic, if people are trying to find you, has two different spellings. I know that on Facebook it's Nomadic, N-O-M-A-D-I-C, although now you are using a different spelling where you've taken that A and flipped it upside down. So now it's N-O-M-V-D-I-C, however still pronounced Nomadic. Is there a significance or can you tell us why that went down?
It's because of black metal, dude. No.
which is a great answer.
Yeah, it's that, and also that if you look up Nomadic on YouTube or anything like that, there's just a plethora. There's millions and millions of bands.
Right.
And we wanted to be recognized considering our song, The Crooked Man, is now a featured song on Spotify. and things like that. So we are going to be making a push once we release our new song. We're going to have a new single out in the next couple months. Pretty much a complete rebrand to the NOMVDIC spelling. So we get NOMVDIC joke all the time, but it is still Nomadic.
Awesome.
But it will eventually be all NOMVDIC.
Fantastic. Awesome. All right. So cool. So we talked a little bit in your bio about the fact that you guys have done some pretty awesome tours last year, and there's a couple coming up this year. Tell us a little bit about your experience on tour last year and what you've got coming up for 2017.
Tour is wild.
Yeah.
I don't really know how else to describe it. You meet a lot of cool people. You form a lot of cool relationships that definitely last.
We signed a dick. In Mississippi.
In Mississippi.
Whoa. All right. Sorry. You signed a dick, as in like, can I have your autograph? Where should we put this on my dick would be good?
It was
perfect.
It was more of, he was like, oh, I don't have anything to sign. You could sign my dick, but he doesn't know who we are. So he said, of course. And that's how it happened,
because we're crazy motherfuckers.
Who held it, him or you?
We each individually held it while we signed it.
Get the fuck out of here. That's the.
Let me just tell
did,
you.
Did you make Did you make him chub up a little bit, so you could all like
he
get
didn't
your
need
names
to.
On it?
It was a big fucking dick.
Holy shit!
So you were able to still use the all caps Nomadic. It wasn't like there. You didn't have to do like lowercase or anything. It was you were able to just.
Yeah, we got four full signatures on that dick. Flaccid. Yeah.
Flaccid. Jesus.
It was a big dick.
That's impressive as hell.
Go him. Yeah.
Do you have any contact info on that guy? It'd be really funny if you got that and put the picture of it with all your signatures on it in liner notes or something.
I will try and find that.
The cover of the next LP or seven inch. Seven inch.
just dicks of fire or something. Dick, yeah. Yeah. This, oh, I got it.
Thank
I got
you.
It.
Thank
and
you.
It would and a little bit would still be cut off just so he looked like he was an 8 inch. Dude, that's amazing, guys. I don't know anybody who's got that story. We signed a dick.
Oh yeah.
First tour, or it's like, yeah, we went on tour for the first time, signed a couple dicks. Life was pretty good. I think it was a pretty good show.
You know,
we made it. That's how you know you're making it.
So. The same night, it was two pairs of boobs and one dick, and we were infinitely more excited about the dick than the two pairs of boobs.
I don't think I can blame you, to be really honest. I boobs are going to come and go all over the place. Not very often dudes going to be like, sign the shit
boobs
out of this.
Boobs are going to come and go.
Oh, I see what you did there. I see what you did there.
I couldn't help it.
I didn't know boob signing was still a thing. I thought that went out in the 90s.
I don't think
but it's definitely
still a
thing. It's
timeless.
In the 90s.
I think it's
timeless.
It
was also in the middle of like rural Mississippi, so.
God. They are 5 years behind, so.
Yeah.
The dream of the 90s is alive in Mississippi.
God, I love you guys.
Oh, my God. Can we start a whole new show just on that?
On tits?
No. Oh, no.
Mm.
I mean, we could.
We probably could, actually.
I love that.
Titties!
I love
it. Yes.
I love how we're bleeding right into our topic of the day.
I love women so much.
All right. So, James, you did mention that you have a studio or a recording studio of your own. Is that right?
Correct, yes.
All right, so what can you tell us about that?
Well, I am a bedroom producer who's way too successful for his own good. Considering I'm in a bedroom. No, but I started this as a hobby just by buying stuff on a Best Buy employee discount.
Yeah. Oh, nice.
Started Forerunner Recordings, and now it's my full-time job.
Holy shit.
And it's pretty cool. And I'm literally a bedroom producer. I don't have a fully treated room or anything like that, but utilizing an apartment in downtown Tampa, I'm able to record full band projects.
Holy shit. That's really awesome. That's really awesome. Good for you. And what's the name what's the name of your studio?
It is called Forerunner Recordings. So hit me up for quality recordings at an affordable price.
Nice. And I'll put a little on the screen for you so you guys can see it. That's rad. And I just realized I sort of cut that first question short. So you've got tour dates set up for this year.
Yes.
So tell us first about the two bands that you're touring with, and what the plan is for those tours.
Sure. Yeah. So like I said, we kind of hit the ground running with tours last year. We booked all of our own tours for September and October of last year. The first time we brought a Bradenton band out called Untamoria. You have pretty much killed that name, by the way. Like, you nailed it, like, right on the head.
Yes.
So good job. They were really cool. They were super young, so we just kept fucking with them pretty much every day. And I think they hate us now.
Shit.
But they were cool. And then the October tour, we went out by ourselves, and that was way, way, way too successful. I don't even know how we did so well on that tour. I mean, in Pennsylvania, we played to like 150 kids in a tiny, tiny room.
Nice.
And co-headlined a festival on accident. It was awesome. But yeah, then we caught in February with Lourdes, who they are Sarasota natives. They're kind of a metal band, they're like a heavy band.
Yeah.
We go out with them for February 3rd, February 12th, and then again February 17th and the 18th.
Amazing.
And we're joined by support from Tusk from South Florida. They're kind of a hardcore band.
Love Tusk, yeah.
And Jinzo from South Carolina on three of the dates.
Nice.
They're kind of a metalcore band. That's and awesome. Then, yeah, we go out again March 3rd to March 17th. It's actually March 2nd to the 26th, but the 3rd to the 17th, we're joined by Aluka, which was booked by our booking agency that we kind of co-book with,
right.
Wavelink Agency. So,
fantastic. Yeah. That's awesome. That'll be cool. I'm asked to tell you that Ethan Slaughter says hi.
Oh, what's up, man?
Hey, what's up? He's our boy.
He just came through on the
Facebook.
3 hours
to see us in South Carolina. That's pretty cool.
That's awesome. So he says, what's up? You guys, so what I didn't realize, which is pretty rad, is that Tampa is kind of a hub for metal. And
How did you not realize that?
Yeah, because I'm a retard.
You're not from here, really.
Because I'm not from here, right. I'm from D.C. So in D.C., we get all kinds of cool stuff. We're punk hardcore all day long. And so I got down here, and somebody was like, oh, yeah, this is like the shit when it comes to metal. And I was like, I had no idea. So have you found that here at home you guys are, you know, welcomed with open arms? Are you getting a lot of home team? Is everybody at home? Are like you pretty well accepted as a band already? Do you find that like the community of metal is pretty awesome down here? Is that a thing?
Kinda.
Be it that Tampa is the death metal capital of the world. It's not, the metal scene's not as thriving anymore.
Right.
It's still alive, but it's not as, I would say, fruitful as it was.
Okay.
The music scene, you're absolutely right. Like, there's tons and tons of music scenes in Tampa, and the heavy music scene is one of the biggest ones. But we are pretty much only accepted in that scene because we're friends with everyone, I would say. Like, pretty much every guy in this band is super, I don't want to say popular, but like we know everyone. Yeah, we're popular. But
we know all bands.
So people come out to our shows, but we are definitely not within the norm of what people are jamming, I guess.
Understand.
But when we headline a show or we book a headliner gig and make it super big, typically there's tons and tons of people there.
Yeah, definitely.
That's awesome. Good problem to have. All right, cool. So you guys, we talked about the studio. Oh, if somebody wanted to find, I know that like I was able to track you guys down and found out that you all also have like a separate merch site as well, as so you can find them, you know, if you search Nomadic, actually NOMADIC, you can find them on Facebook. So make sure you go to Facebook right now and hit follow or like or whatever the hell
Facebook
you have to hit.
Facebook.com/nomadicband. And that will be changed soon, but don't ignore that for now. Nomadic band, facebook.com/nomadicband.
Go ahead and like it now at that, and then when they change it, you'll already still be liking it, so it won't matter anyway. So there's definitely a merch site. What's the link for the merch site if people want to go check out some tees and stuff?
It is nomvdicmerch.bigcartel.com. So it's Nomadic merch, but it's the spelling with a V, .bigcartel.com. We have shirts, CDs, other stuff, patches. It's a good time.
Yeah. And again, you're about to read that right there. Oh, if I'm gonna even do it, I'm gonna like do the graphic all slow and shit, because I'm a baller. So awesome. And then if they wanted to reach out to you otherwise, is Facebook the best way to do it, or how else can they follow you?
We also have an Instagram page that we're pretty active on called at Nomadic Band. So it's the same as the Facebook link.
Okay.
Would be the best way, other than our personal Facebook pages, that's the best way to get a hold of us.
Awesome. Do you want to plug your personal Facebooks, or do you want to know?
Just look me up, James Lewis. I'm sexy, and Nick's even sexier.
Nicholas Zayas, but NICOLAS, no H, because I'm Hispanic. So.
Oh, and the important thing, everyone watching, and this is the biggest plug, go follow us on Spotify, please. NOMVDIC. That page. We have two pages. The other one got taken over by a bunch of other artists. This one, we need everyone to follow.
Right. So go ahead and do that. I'll make sure that not only I'm going to plug it again, because the song that we're about to play after this interview is actually on that. You'll be able to find that the very first thing you find when you look them up. So I'll make sure I put all that information down here for you and throughout the track. So you'll find it. Don't worry. I promise. Awesome. So we've definitely got people finding you guys. Is there anything else that we've missed today? What else do people need to know about Nomadic?
We definitely want to give a shout out to some of our sponsors.
Please.
Yeah. You want to go first?
Yeah. Trash Clothing.
Band Life Clothing.
Once again, shout out to Wavelength Agency.
10 and 8 Management. Eyes Up Productions for recordings, obviously. All of our friends. Lights Out Recordings.
Zeal Coffee Roasters.
Yeah, we got sponsored by Zeal. Isn't that cool?
That is awesome.
Yeah. Who else? Do we have any? Ibanez. Yeah, Chili's Bar and Grill. Chili's Baby Back Ribs.
Barbecue Sauce. Baby Back Ribs.
What else? Ibanez Guitars. Diadero Strings.
Yeah. Awesome.
And that's pretty much it.
That's a good list. Yeah. I don't know if I'm going to put all those up, but you heard them here first.
You don't have to. Put like three of them.
Okay, deal.
Definitely Chili's. Chili's. So four.
Oh, delicious.
I want my baby back, baby back.
Are you hungry?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we're doing food.
Actually, I prefer Applebee's.
Applebee's? What?
Yeah.
What's wrong with you?
Right, I like them both.
Many things. We don't have enough time
now
to
with Applebee's. I don't
know. Fuck off.
That's a whole show. That's a whole show. We're gonna call you guys back on that show too, and be like, we'll let you be on
apps,
Team Chili's.
Yep.
Late night munchies.
Where? Yeah.
Late night, you obviously want to go to Applebee's, but Chili's is quantitatively a better restaurant.
I haven't been to an Applebee's since the 90s. Let's put it that way.
Mm. Oh shit, Bees got tight.
Yeah, whatever. Who'd they pick up?
It got way worse.
They picked up Bobby Flay or one of those dicks for a little while.
I don't care.
Some chef. Some like
Bobby Flay's tight. Bobby Flay is super tight.
I would fight him in the street.
I don't care. He makes delicious food.
He's going to try to fight me with grill tools, and I'm going
to
fight him.
He taught me how to make
street.
Delicious burgers.
They are pretty good. All right. So anyway, we're back to you dudes. Guys, thank you so much. Does anybody else have a question for these guys before we let them ride?
I really need to get that Instagram page.
Sorry. I ate way too much at brunch. I'm fucking tired.
That's totally okay.
Sorry, dude.
Normally you would get a curveball like, what would your tombstone say, or what kitchen utensil would you be? Nothing. He's not there today. It's all right. We're gonna let you guys. We're letting you guys off.
I'm fuzzy. I'm very fuzzy.
Can we ask you one question before we go?
Please.
Being Sarasota natives, do you enjoy the restaurant Station 400?
Station 400.
Yeah. I haven't been there in a minute.
I haven't been there in a while. Never been there. I don't live in Sarasota.
Love that restaurant with my entire life.
With your whole life. All right, so there it is. Station 400.
They have good pancakes.
Do they?
They have very good pancakes. Oh, yeah.
Sandwiches and everything.
Sandwiches.
Yeah, it's damn good. It's damn good. I was just there not too long ago, and it was yummy still. It was good. Yeah, it was good. You know, it's in a weird spot, though, and so, like, I don't get to it that often.
4th Street and Lemon.
Yeah, it's yummy. Yeah, we'll plug them. It's a good spot. We love
Plugged.
It. And so does Nomadic, so now you're in. Dude, you know what? I almost forgot. You guys are coming down here pretty soon, aren't you?
Yes, we will be there at Kelly's Live right on 41.
Metal.
I think it's in between Fruitvilla and Bee Ridge.
Yes, that is correct.
It is.
It's near my house.
It is. We're playing there for the Lourdes package with a bunch of other bands. It's called Death Fest, I guess. It's a Sunday. It is Super Bowl Sunday. However, you can just like watch the Super Bowl and then come and see us. We're playing that late. If you're drunk, just like get an Uber, like an Uber Select, preferably.
Kelly's Live is so tight.
Or you can just fucking TiVo that damn game and go do something fucking
purposeful
with your life instead of sitting around watching football.
They can tune into our podcast.
Yeah,
totally.
Like,
yes.
TV.
Totally. That's a better idea. Tune into Ghost Riot Radio. Go to the show. Watch
Skip
Facebook,
because
Facebook will tell you every
it's
fucking
a Sunday.
Right,
yeah. Come say what was...
Facebook will tell you every play-by-play and who won way before
in
you even...
In meme form.
Yeah. Unless you're cool about the commercials, which just makes you a consumer, and that's sad, too. Anyway, folks...
Coming from someone that really has everything consumer.
That loves to support his people. That's true. It's true. Well, what can I say?
Yeah.
We're Americans.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So, guys, super glad you could join us today. If there's nothing else, we're just going to let you ride because we got a song to play from you guys so people can check you out. But we're going to go ahead and let you go. We really appreciate it. Hopefully, we get to go. We will. I'm going to do my best to be at that show. So I'll make sure we come up and say what's up. And, you know,
it's free. No excuses.
Yeah, we're just going to all.
I love Kelly's Live. Yeah. I've only been chased out by, you know, 5 neo-Nazis from there.
I think that's a good number. That's a pretty low number.
Is there something we don't know? Yeah,
like dude, okay, seriously. I was there a couple of months back, and I was hanging out with my friend Joey, who owns a food truck called Mother Trucking Good.
What's up,
and
Joey?
That's awesome.
While he was making food, this drunk racist guy walked onto his truck with his shirt off, and he had a giant swastika tattooed on his stomach.
Oh, my goodness.
Joey was like, what the fuck are you doing? And that guy ended up having to be, like, taken off the premises because he was getting in people's faces, showing off his like racist tattoos and shit.
Awesome.
It's like, yeah. So yeah. That's
sounds
Kelly.
Like a party.
That's not everybody that hangs out at Kelly's Live, but that's the kind of draw that you get there.
If anybody knows that guy, you let him know that Ghost Riot Radio will happily help him get that removed. We're just going to tie him down in the backyard and cut that bitch right off his chest. So yeah, we hate the fuck out of people like that, just so you guys know. So if, like, you know, if you ever want to send
that's
us people for us to just hate real fucking loud, we will do that openly and honestly. Anyway, so yeah, we'll see you then.
Nomadic does not support
this. Yeah. Yeah.
Throw that out there.
Just in case you didn't hear that, Nomadic said they don't support that shit either. So these dudes are fucking rad. So go check them out. Kelly's Live. What day was that again?
2/5, Sunday, February 5th.
Sunday the 5th.
Super Bowl Sunday.
Stupid Bowl Sunday.
The big game.
What are we going to do for months after
we're
going to
fucking watch the Puppy Bowl. Fuck the Super Bowl.
Oh, my God.
Puppy
I
Bowl.
Love watching
that's
Puppy Bowl.
That's always way more fulfilling. Way more
who doesn't
fulfilling.
Love puppies, though?
So
everybody.
Fucking,
you have a smile on your face the entire time.
Nazis don't like puppies.
And they
fucking
have kittens.
Fuck Nazis, dude.
They have kittens,
Rachel,
like,
bullshit.
Hanging
how
out.
How do you not fucking like Nazis?
Oh, man.
They should all be punched in the face.
Nomadic hates Nazis but loves puppies.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. Oh, hashtag love puppies, hate Nazis.
Yes.
And women. And women's rights.
And women.
And women.
Hashtag don't be a dick.
Women should be assumed, which is part of what we're going to get into in a little bit. So, dudes, thanks again. Hashtag, our other hashtag around here is don't be a dick. So feel free to just hashtag don't be a dick on everything.
Absolutely.
Scott Braun says, Ghost Riot Radio, fighting the good fight against Nazis. Ty says, those donuts last night.
Oh, my God, those fucking donuts. Yeah, Amish Donut Company, what's up?
Dude.
Want to sponsor our shit?
You guys want to... We'll meet you guys. We'll meet you guys on the 5th.
I mean,
we'll all
so
become
good.
Best buds. You can sign my dick if you want, and then we will bring you back down here. We'll do some partying. You guys will meet some of these people, and we'll do some food truck rallies.
Hell
good
yeah!
Times. All right, so good. We're gonna let you guys roll. It's time to play some music. Thank you guys so much for joining us. We're gonna go ahead and cut you out here, and we'll catch you on the next one. Thanks again, guys. Take it easy.
Later, dude.
Oh, okay. Bye.
Bye. Please,
all right, dude. So folks. That was, so that feedback was them. Hopefully that's not on there. All right, cool. Anyway, dudes, we were super happy to have you. Hopefully now you're going to catch us on the Facebook feed for the rest of this show. Folks, if you want to check them out, don't forget to check out YouTube, where you can find them at Nomadic, N-O-M-A-D-I-C, where some of today's tracks plus a few others are available, as well as don't forget to hit their subscribe button. And while you're there, just go to Ghost Riot Radio and hit my subscribe button, too. The track I'm about to play is also available on Spotify for your listening enjoyment, so make sure you check out Spotify as well. This is Nomadic with a track called Crooked Man.
painting breaking limbs. Yeah, I watch myself again to hate never ends.
God, I just fuck that shit. Just will just rip your face clean right off, dudes. That was Nomadic. These dudes are awesome. That was the Crooked Man. If you guys are checking out their YouTube or Spotify, you can find the Crooked Man there. So make sure you check them out, dudes. We're super happy to have you. It was super awesome. Oh, you know what? I opened you guys up, but I'm not going to yet because we're gonna do some really awesome shit that I like to do all the time. Shout out to Scott Braun for creating a new track, which is now the theme music to my favorite section of this show. Folks, it's time for The Week in Weed, brought to you by Normal.org. If you're not familiar with the Normal.org, they are the National Organization for the Reform of Marijuana Law. You should go check them out right now at Normal, N-O-R-M-L.org, where you can find out all about cannabis laws in your community, what's happening in the news, and really just some cool shit about weed. So it's a fucking good idea. So go check them out, N-O-R-M-L.org. Let's see what they have for us this week in The Week in Weed. It turns out that legislators... God damn it. I fucking... Yeah, they do. They suck. These cats are fucking up right now. Legislators in a number of states are pushing forward measures to delay the enactment of several voter-initiated marijuana laws. I fucking hate you guys. In Arkansas, House lawmakers unanimously voted in favor of legislation, House Bill 1026, to postpone the deadline for establishing the state's new medical marijuana program by 60 days. Go fuck yourself. 53% of voters approved issue six on Election Day, which called on lawmakers to regulate the production and dispensing of medical cannabis within 120 days. Y'all are fucking up. Wait, it gets worse. In Maine, we talked about this last week, leading House and Senate lawmakers have endorsed emergency legislation LD88 to delay retail marijuana sales by at least 3 months. Under the voter-initiated law, rules regulating the commercial marijuana market are actually supposed to be operational by January 1st of 2018. North Dakota fucking up too. Senate lawmakers unanimously passed emergency legislation Senate Bill 2154 to postpone the deadline for the enactment of North Dakota Compassionate Care Act. 64% of voters backed the measure, which gave lawmakers a 90-day window to regulate the distribution of medical marijuana. Massachusetts, you're fucking up too. Lawmakers previously enacted legislation imposing a 6-month delay on the licensed production and retail of sales of marijuana. Legislators are also debating making additional changes to the law, including raising the proposed retail sales tax and limiting the number of plants an adult may grow at home. What the fuck? In Florida, health regulators are also calling for changes to Amendment 2, which passed with a 71% vote. What the fuck, Florida? Anyway, Normal Executive Director Eric Altieri strongly criticized the proposed changes and delays, calling them, quote, an affront to the democratic process. He added, quote, voters have lived with the failings of marijuana prohibition for far too long already. Lawmakers have a responsibility to abide by the will of the voters and to do so in a timely manner, unquote. Eric, we fucking love you, man. Keep doing what you do, brother. Keep doing it. All right, so now that I'm angry, let's talk about other shit. In other news, the American Legion of Indiana passed a resolution on Sunday calling on state lawmakers to permit veterans access to marijuana as a therapeutic remedy. We definitely stand behind that as well. The resolution acknowledges that legalizing cannabis access will reduce opioid addiction and overdose deaths and urges members of the Indiana General Assembly to, quote, amend state legislation to remove restrictions from marijuana and reclassify it in a category that, at minimum, will recognize cannabis as a drug with potential medical value, unquote. During its national convention in September, the American Legion called on Congress to remove marijuana from its Schedule I classification under federal law. Please fucking do that. Get your shit together. With nearly 2.5 million members, the American Legion is the largest veterans advocacy organization in the United States. So, guys, we stand behind you 110%. We're all about A, veterans, B, removing marijuana as a Schedule I drug because it's just fucking stupid. All right, so enough about that. Don't take my word for it, folks, but nearly 7 in 10 police officers believe that marijuana ought to be legally regulated for either medical or recreational purposes, according to a Pew Research study or survey, of nearly 8,000 law enforcement personnel. 32% of respondents supported legalizing the plant for adults, while another 37% agreed that marijuana ought to be regulated for medical purposes only. 30% of police said that marijuana ought to continue to be illegal for any reason. There's always those. Law enforcement views continue to be more conservative than those of the general public, 81% of whom endorse the legalization of medical cannabis and 60% of whom support broader legalization for adults. So even the cops are getting on board, guys. So what can you do? And by the way, folks, that is the end of The Week in Weed, brought to you by normal.org. Please make sure you go check out NORML.org to go check out everything that we've said here today, plus all kinds of other information. And just so you know, I did this disclaimer out of order, but you need to know for sure that, as always, Ghost Riot Radio is my show and mine alone. The comments and opinions made by me or this show do not necessarily reflect the opinions of my guests, any business, company, or organization that is mentioned on this show. Please do not hold my guests accountable for my comments. Thanks for being open-minded. Hashtag don't be a dick. So we're going to open these guys back up. Don't forget, if you are in the Florida area, even though they're trying to fuck with us right now, you should go check out docmj.com. If you're trying to find out whether or not you now qualify for amendment to the Compassionate Care Act that is now, hopefully stays alive here in Florida, go check them out. That's docmj.com. You're going to take a quick survey. They'll get back to you almost immediately. They'll set you up and get you started on the road to that compassionate care that you need. And don't forget that if you are looking for other people who are in your area who are interested in the same stuff that you are, especially the subject of cannabis, you should download an app called Hi There.
Hi There.
Hi There is a social app for cannabis consumers and aficionados alike. If you decide to download the app, you can look me up because my profile is under Nick Noble. That's K-N-O-W-B-L-E. Do us all a favor, though, and be careful with what you decide to say on that site. The federal government is still not convinced, Schedule 1, about cannabis, and I don't want anyone here to get in trouble. So just, you know, stop asking me if I'm going to sell you weed because I'm fucking not. All right, gang, don't forget the phone line is open here and we want to hear from you. Today we're talking women's rights, which is the perfect weekend for this right now, and we want to hear from you. So if you were one of the million plus who marched yesterday, male or female, we want to hear about your experience. And maybe you're just proud to be you and you want to let us know, so we want to hear it all. Call us at 813-343-4798. Folks, as you well know, yesterday was a pretty significant day in our history as over 1 million women and men marched in cities all over the world in support of women's rights.
Get it, girls.
2.2.
We here at Ghost Riot Radio, hold on, I'm going to answer this phone call real quick in the middle of my speech.
Yo, what up? Who dat?
Folks, welcome to Ghost Riot Radio. What's your name and where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Sarasota, Florida.
And your name is?
My name is Hank. I'm calling from Sarasota.
Hank from Sarasota. I can see your caller ID, by the way.
so
Hank from Sarasota, what? Welcome to Ghost Riot Radio. Tell us what you got to say.
I just wanted to say, first of all, I'm a long time listener.
Oh, thank you. We appreciate that.
Long time.
First time caller. I just wanted to let y'all know that I appreciate what you do for the community and for making my little heart happy. I see you looking at that screen there, Madison. I see what you're doing. Anyway,
thanks, Hank. Sorry.
I just wanted to call and say I love y'all, and I would have been at the women's march yesterday, but I'm actually sick as a dog right now. But I do appreciate that. Hank, friends and family of mine all across the country.
Hank, were you happening to be working at Trader Joe's yesterday?
No, sir. not.
Hey, Hank, also, I still need you to take my passport photo.
Hey, man, like I said, there's lots of rules and regulations for them.
It's got to be a white background and I can't be smiling. That's it.
I know. You go to the website, you see, man, it's like, it's heavy stuff. I ain't going to get arrested because I take your picture the wrong way.
All right. Anyway, okay, that's done. Personal business is done with Hank.
Hank, we appreciate your call. Thank you so much. We hope you feel better, and thank you for all of your support at Ghost Riot Radio.
Thank you, sir. I love y'all. Have a wonderful afternoon.
We love you too, buddy. You take care. Oh. So good.
Bye, Scott.
Super. Oh, so funny. Do me a favor. Oh, shit. I almost killed myself. No, unplug that mic from, or those headphones from the back of that.
Okay.
That might change a little bit. Yeah, it's
813-343-4798. Yeah, call folks, in Derek from Texas.
No, don't.
We're waiting for you.
No. All right, so
he definitely did not march with women yesterday.
No.
Was he just like an asshole they called?
Yeah.
No, he's not the friendliest guy. He's actually super nice. He seems very polite, but he just has some opinions that are a little bit strong.
And so not very even-keeled.
Not call back, yeah. I'm going to continue with my rant real quick. Folks, we here at Ghost Riot Radio were unfortunately unable to attend any of the marches yesterday for outstanding circumstances, but hopefully you're following Ghost Riot Radio on social media and saw our post honoring all women everywhere for being amazing human beings who deserve our love and respect. Since I was unable to physically be present at the event and show my support today here on Ghost Riot Radio, this is all about amazing women and women's rights and us supporting the fact that we stand behind that 110%. So
yeah.
Please don't be shy. If you have a voice that needs to be heard, we want to hear from you during today's show. Please give us a call and tell us about your experience during the march or just an awesome story that you think is worth being heard, or you want to shout out somebody who you think is just phenomenal. We want to hear about all of those people. So give us a call, 813-343-4798. In the meantime, I'm getting back to the two guests who I have with us today. We're super happy to have both of you ladies. Sam, let's start with you because I know for sure. Actually, I just found out just a second ago that Gisselle also was part of the march. You were part of the march in St. Pete yesterday. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. Can you tell us a little bit about your experience with that and tell us a little bit about how it went, because obviously I got to see the DC footage online. There's lots of stuff, but I didn't.
My brother was there
in DC.
Yeah, a lot of my friends were there. Yeah. I was gonna go to that, but ended up having to work. You know, I couldn't make it happen,
right?
Flight wise and stuff. But
sure,
I would have loved to be there.
Awesome,
been awesome.
But you still got to do St. Pete. So tell us how it was in St. Pete.
It was really awesome. I mean, it was surprising to see a small city as St. Pete with that many people turn out, because it was like 20,000 plus people. It was like the largest, I mean, you probably saw the largest gathering ever, like, to support something like that in St. Pete. But I also just thought that the marches in general, like, yes, it's a women's march and it, you know, is really important that we did that, but it's not just women. Like, it was men, absolutely, gay, trans. It was like to fight for everyone, which was really awesome. So the fact that, like, we had over millions of people across the world, you know, taking a stand on things together, I definitely cried yesterday when I was watching all this stuff.
Really,
like, it was really amazing. And everybody there was extremely, like, loving towards each other.
Yeah.
I just read an article recently that every single women's march in America, there was not one single arrest.
No.
Which is amazing.
Good. Because well done, America.
Yeah. So, like, well the fact done. That America. Yeah, the fact that there's, like, not one violent, you know, outbreak, no violence, you know, when we made such an impact, like, in my lifetime, I've never seen something like that.
I think it's
never
more
happened.
Yeah. It's more impactful that there isn't violence, because then people are going to take it more seriously, because there's the violence. I think that
it adds
people.
To,
yeah. Like, it well. It. I think that people read the violence as just like, look at these nannies. They're fucking. They're pissed off and they're, you know, they need their bottle.
These millennial children.
That yeah, and they just don't give a shit. But like, if you can do stuff and do it peacefully, I think it's more impactful. Sometimes there does need to be violence. However, I don't think that, you know,
no,
you don't have to smash Starbucks windows every fucking day.
No, and those people, I ruined it for a lot of people. Like, they're anti-fascists, anti-the government, you know.
Yeah,
like,
anti-establishment in general.
Yeah, the fact that they were doing that just made it shitty for people. Mm-hmm. Like, my little brother was there and ended up getting burns on his leg from one of those grenades that went off. I mean, like, he's there, peacefully protesting for trans and, like,
yeah,
for
it turns it about them, and it just, like, completely diverges all the attention from the actual movement.
Mm-hmm. Well, and, like, how you were saying, like, about, like, millennials, like, how everybody, you know, kind of, like, makes jokes about our generation, you
we
know?
Just
which
too much.
I understand where people are coming from, because, I mean, even though people, a lot of us marched, I can guarantee probably, like, not every one of them voted for Hillary, and not any of them probably, like, a lot of them hardly voted, you know. So like a lot of them are, you know, boasting about this, like, movement, which is amazing, and they're supporting something that's good, but when it came down to actually doing something, you know, about it, I don't know. But
no, you're absolutely right. And I, you know, so this is the first time in history that anything ever like this has ever happened.
Mm-hmm.
For so many people, not only in this country but globally, to come out right after an inauguration and stand up for what they believe in is phenomenal. So huge, huge, huge shout out to all of you who were part of that. But you know, it's funny. Okay, here's interesting. Omar says, "What about men's rights? How come women always get the child in custody cases?"
Because it's the mother.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. All right, so
and they don't always.
Yeah, they don't always. I don't think that in every single case it's necessarily fair that the mother gets the child.
Absolutely not.
But if you actually like look into feminism, you'd see that feminists fight for equality in all cases,
right.
And that's one of the cases too.
And that's,
you know, it's not to say that like women are ahead of men. We just want to be on the same level.
Same level, mm-hmm. Right? And that's. Each person is individually different. Some people are douchebags. Some people aren't douchebags. Men and women equally.
Exactly.
But everybody needs to be treated the same and start out on the same plane. Can either one of you tell me, it's obvious in music, in media, literally everywhere where women as a whole are either belittled or I hate to say it, but like really... sort of still that like something to look at, just like pretty picture, right? Like all you are is something physical and not anything beyond that. Yeah, I can imagine. So what about, tell us about some of the experiences maybe that you've had where, you know, you recognize that in a way that was different than just like what's mainstream.
In a way that's different from mainstream? Well, I was raised pretty like conservative, mm-hmm. Hispanic, like traditional Cuban.
Yep.
So I was like put to this weird standard of how I had to behave and act that was just kind of weird. I wasn't allowed to wear makeup till I was 15. I wasn't allowed to pluck my unibrow till I was 15. It was, you know, like certain things, you know, it's silly, but it's just kind of like, it was weird that like I couldn't like, you know, cut my hair short even though we lived in Florida and right. My hair had to be below my ass. And it's just like, dude, like it's hot.
Right.
You know, like just simple little things like that, that I'm like, why am I supposed to be doing all these crazy weird things? And it's like, because you're a girl and it's about womanhood and, you know, blah, blah, blah. And this is and that. And I'm like, but why?
Right.
Like, why do I...
Why isn't it about individuality?
So stupid. Like, why do I have to do that? And meanwhile, my brother, who's like 5 years younger than me, got to do all these awesome things that I still wouldn't be able to do, like play in our backyard when there was like another small child there that just happened to be a boy.
Right.
It's just crazy that like I was like, okay, well, I'm older and I know all these things more than my child, like 5-year-old brother.
Right.
But I'm a girl, so I can't even play in my own backyard.
Yeah, that's... See, that's so
it's a little extreme, but it's really frustrating.
And that's the other thing is that these are not new ideas. It's not like this has never been it's always been an issue. This is something that's so ingrained in certain cultures that it's going to take a really long time to start to break down those things. But I think that we're fortunately I hate and love this situation, but I think that we're now in a culture where information is readily available. There's no hiding from anything anymore. When you fuck up, it's everywhere. And if you don't think that it is, I dare you to try, because I guarantee that there will be 5 people around you with camera phones and a heartbeat, and that shit will end up on every social media site known to man.
Yeah.
And so now we're in the information age. And I don't like it, and I do like it. But again, as an old dude, I come from an era where I didn't have any of this at one point. There was a childhood where, like...
Yeah, I didn't have computers until I was, like, I think 10, 11 in my house.
Yeah.
Yeah, same.
Like, we had beepers come out whenever I was around. You know what I mean? Like,
I used to have a beeper.
Like,
oh, my God. Yeah. Beepers were...
I had many pagers.
Tamagotchi were like the shit back in the day.
Oh, yeah.
I killed my digital Tamagotchis. Thing. Oh, I had like 300 of them.
I killed them all.
That Sega Genesis, like those kind of like throwbacks.
Yeah. Sega Genesis.
GameCube. Some Super Smash Brothers.
It's like the bridge between analog and digital, just like that nice.
Yeah, right. Yeah. So they.
Nice mix of both.
In school, I'm going to fuck this up. In school, we just did in the first couple of months of school, we talked about being a digital native. And that was about like. You were around for the beginning of it when you had an Atari, and that was the coolest shit that ever happened to you,
mm-hmm.
right? And so anyway, I'm getting off topic, but the point is still that now we're in an information age where when people do shitty things are seen. And so people are like, oh, it's the worst time in history. And it's like, no, it's fucking not. You just know now.
Yeah, pretty
much. You just know now. Now you don't get to hide from it anymore. You have to fucking deal with it because it's in your face. You can't sit around with your bullshit ideals and think that that shit's going to be okay anymore, because now we know that as a people, the only way that we can be a people is to do it together.
Yeah, that's why I thought it was hilarious, like, the whole address the right after the march, like, oh, you know, our inauguration was, you know, hacked, numbers weren't real. Like, are you fucking kidding me? Have you seen the images? Like, we didn't just make those up. Like, no. Okay, even if they were, whatever, more than 250,000 people that showed up, like, you, that literally, what happened yesterday shits on those numbers.
Absolutely.
And shits it's on. Like... Completely Listen, wipes it out. So
2009 shits on what happened.
Yeah, it's irrelevant. Day. Like they yeah. are the fact that even that someone at that high office. I mean, it's not surprising to me, but like that's what you're gonna literally
yeah.
waste no. public time and make a statement about no. on live television. Like no. okay,
no, and there's still
so many
you know,
more important things to cover.
Yeah,
like, yeah. Well,
the know. Only thing I thought that was really horrible that I did start seeing, and I'm sure you guys did, is like how a lot of people against Trump. Started like, you know, pretty much cyberbullying his youngest son, the 10-year-old.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't see that at all.
It's a
I heard about
a that. Lot of Twitter stuff happened where like people were straight up making fun of him, calling him a demon, saying that he like looks like a loser. And I'm like, this kid is 10 years old. He That's didn't choose who his father yeah. is. Like yeah.
There's something to be said yeah. for
like fight against something that you actually believe in, and like, yes, you can hate a man that's in office for cruel things and like racial, you know, racist
right. Right.
stuff that he's saying. But
proven.
That
proven.
Kid's yeah. going to grow up hating like the general.
But
American
he's a little kid. He's a little child. Right. I mean,
doesn't here's, benefit anybody.
Here's either. The answer. If you are fighting just to be fighting, then you're an idiot.
Yeah. Like go to sleep.
Right.
Like, go to bed. Turn your computer off.
You're an idiot. If you're fighting and you're literally, you know, if the only stance you have is what somebody looks like or literally nothing, you literally have nothing on a 10-year-old. If that's your stance, yeah. then you're doing it fucking wrong. If you have something that's educated and you come at it in an educated way and have an educated, well-thought-out argument, then that...
Not hateful.
Then that makes sense. Otherwise, you're a fucking asshole and you deserve everything that's going to backlash on you.
Yes.
And so this is a lesson now that I think is really important that should be taught in schools, in my opinion. You need to know, and we call it cyberbullying. I think that sucks. It's not just bullying. It's just the most stupid of people proving hashtag don't be a dick. Yeah, she's right. Sarah's here today too. We're gonna. I wish you'd come on. So
she'll come on.
Okay, good. So. But we're right. We're dead on. If you're just being an asshole for the sake of being an asshole and your greatest argument is he looks like the spawn of Satan, then you're a fucking idiot. The 10-year-old has nothing to do with anything, and he has a chance to go on and be completely opposite of everybody in his family. So if you're opposed to the Trump family, don't take it out on a fucking 10-year-old.
Mm-hmm.
Do yourself a favor and go fucking read a book, get some fucking information in your brain, and then sit back and wait for things to happen, because currently you're changing nothing by belittling people, which takes us right back.
And it just starts shit. Which it's like hecklers at comedy shows. Like, why the fuck are you here?
It does.
Like,
and it takes us like, right why? Back to the fact that you need to start treating women in the same way that you would want to be treated.
Blink
and,
twice, Malia.
And listen, we
I mean, you guys all saw the dance, right? That was really painful to watch.
You know what I really liked was the
fact I love Melania.
It was bad.
Sarah shared with me that I guess there's a meme going around where Melania's face looks like somebody told the joke and she doesn't get it. it's really good.
She doesn't get
the punchline.
Hmm. Oh. But she is a model. It's
right. Okay. So here's the thing. Here's the thing about. Here's my stance on her.
And she's fucking smoking hot. So whatever.
She is hot. Yeah. She is hot. In fact,
her nudes just came out.
Did anybody see Clinton get caught fucking checking her out by Hillary?
Oh yeah, Hillary was like,
"Really, dude?" Yeah. So funny. But listen, folks. This is life.
I love.
Okay.
Way to go, Bill.
Here's one thing that we'll never be able to delete. We are opposite sexes, right? And we're supposed to be attracted to each other. Sometimes we're attracted to the same sexes, and that's totally awesome too. But. For years, right, the norm was to be attracted to the opposite sex. And so that shit is always going to be there. And people being sexually creepy is always going to be a thing, unfortunately. There are going to be people who do it properly and can handle it. And there are going to be people who have problems and won't be able to handle it. So that's a whole nother issue. But either way, you need to be treating everybody that you involve in your life with respect, male or female. And that's the point of this whole shit. Whether or not you believe... that, you know, whatever you believe, anybody who you're trying to A, involve into your life, B, be friends with, C, and almost more importantly, like start solid relationships with, all of those people deserve respect 110%. Right. Literally across the board. No matter what sex you are, no matter who it is, everybody deserves to be respected. Whether you make a ton of money or you make literally no fucking money and you're asking me for money on the street, I'm not going to tell you to go fuck yourself and get a job. I'm going to tell you that you deserve, you know, like, I'm sorry, I can't help you. If that's really the case, that's a whole nother game altogether.
I did read this really interesting article, though, about, it was pretty much like saying, like, once this next, the baby boomer generation passes away, like, they're kind of arguing, like, is racism going to die? Because, like, a lot of millennials and stuff aren't racist.
They're indoctrinating children.
Yeah.
Yeah. And there are a lot of, you know, young Trump supporters out there. Like,
which are so, it's so sad because this is an amazing podcast, like, what we're doing, what we're talking about right now. Agreed. But, like, this is literally going to make nothing happen.
No major impact.
Which sucks. Right. And it, like, breaks my heart that, like, people still will just go on, like, hating each other. But,
yeah. Let's start a hashtag prove it. Let's just start sharing that right now. Prove it.
You know, just seeing cool people talk about it in a nice, mild-mannered way. Yeah. Hopefully, like, gets one person to at least, like, think about it, because there's such a stigma on, like,
you know what I've
feminism,
really...
everything
in a whole, and all the other stuff we were marching for.
What I've really liked over the past, God, probably decade that I've seen, especially, I appreciate going to punk rock or hardcore show. Frequently, and the amount of women coming out to the hardcore shows in these female fronted hardcore bands, it's such a fucking breath of fresh air to a scene that was dominated by men so fucking long, and there's fucking awesome bands now. There's this fucking band, and I talk about them all the time because I believe in their word. They're called Go Away from Fort Lauderdale. Oh my God. This little girl, she's about probably yay high. Her name is Christina, and she
they're
fronts.
They're fucking awesome.
They are fucking awesome, and they have a great message, you know, against animal cruelty. Fuck the man. Don't grab my fucking pussy. Fuck rapists. You know, equality
like
and all this stuff.
They're like,
oh my God.
They like started that.
and then there's cooler bands, a little bit softer, like Kayatana from Philadelphia. It's just like, oh, there's so much good shit coming out. And it's like, thank you, women.
Coat Hangers.
Thank you.
Paint, like all of them. They're just. Yeah.
What about female front? My Memory Remains from last weekend.
Oh, yeah.
They're like, there's just so much good shit going on.
Now we just need a march for like trans people.
That
needs to fucking happen because like that seriously just gets brushed under the rug all the time. And like, it's amazing that we like yesterday they were included in what we marched for, a lot of us. But the fact that this last year was like literally like genocide for trans people, like it was the highest year of murders like for them. And no one's really doing any. I mean, like I posted something today that there was like something like, I can't remember the number, but it was a really high amount of Muslims that protested against ISIS, and like the mainstream media didn't even fucking mention it, and like our march is everywhere.
Yeah.
And it was millions in like that were protesting against ISIS. It's like certain things will only get, you know, pressworthy when we're like, oh my God, look, like Paris and Prague and like all these places are supporting Trump, like, you know, fighting against it with us too. Like, why aren't we doing that for other people, you know?
Right. And we You can't claim to be the greatest power in the world and not be better people. You can't be closed-minded to the fact that you are the most powerful and then act like a fucking dictator. It makes no fucking sense at all. And if that's the way that you're going to be, you should get the fuck out.
Mm-hmm.
If you think that all you heard for the last year
the
and a half
thing about
was like, "Oh, you don't like Trump, you're not an American, you should get the fuck out." That's not true, because our forefathers built this country on the idea that we were all going to be free. Free. And you're like, oh, well, that makes me free to be a fucking closed-minded piece of shit. Good. Do that, but know that the rest of us are fucking coming.
And kill yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go ahead and kill yourself.
We are coming in droves. And if you think that you outnumber the number of people that fucking want this to be a fucking
peaceful,
loving society, you're fucking out of your mind. And I'll start a civil war
Well, and that's why it's really awesome, because yesterday just proves that, like, love and, like, you know, respect and stuff like that will literally always win over someone who wants to hate someone. I mean, you've seen it, like, in even just car accidents. If someone gets, like, in an accident on the road, like, you know, civilians will just try to help them. It's like people come together to try to protect one another when stuff happens. And, you know, I mean,
I hate Facebook. And I'm
honest, I can't fucking go awful. On it anymore, dude. I can't. But, it's bad.
All the emotions on Facebook.
Right, a lot.
And if I see another fucking animal cruelty video in the morning, right when I wake up and have my coffee, and then it ruins my fucking day, I'm just going to cry.
But here's the thing. The stuff that you stop and check out is the stuff that's positive. And it's like, look at this person doing a good deed. And we're all like, oh, fuck yeah, I like the shit out of that. I
love this.
Right. But it's like, but then the same people turn around and they're like, oh, well, you know, I'm not really into you because you're not the same color as me. And, oh, I'm not really into you because you believe in different shit. It's fucking chaos.
It doesn't make sense. Oh, yeah, I love this. This was like a cool, like, social experiment. It's fucking rad. But I can't really get down with you because you don't believe in Jesus. So, there's just a lot of fucking dumb, closed-minded shit.
It was really eye-opening, though. I know. This is like, that's why when you told me we were talking about this shit, I was like, ooh, all right, that's a fucking intense subject because shit might get heated. But, like, at least this election, everything like that, weeded out the fucking garbage people in all of our lives. We could, like, we saw them being like, oh my God, I love Pence. And, like, you know, just electrocute gay out of people, do it. Like, and then I was like, oh, yeah, cool, you're a fucking shitty person. Unfriend you from my life.
They came out of the woodwork. The most frustrating part for me was just seeing, like, the sympathizers, the ones that didn't want to, like, you know, jump right into the racism, but we're like patting it on the back kind of thing. Like,
give him a chance.
Like, it's okay. He's totally doing all these things. Like, give him a chance. And you know, if Obama did any of those things or like even hinted to any a fraction of what Trump does, they would have, like, you know, been burning even more effigies.
Well, and the really amazing thing about all of it is that a lot of people for Trump keep, you know, fighting and saying like, oh, well, they're just a bunch of crybabies. They need to accept that he's president. We're not, none of us have not accepted it. Like, we are accepting, like, yes, he did everything that he needed to do to, like, be, like, put into office. He, like, swore an oath. You know, he's legally our president. Like, we get that. We've accepted it. But we don't need to, like,
but the majority of people did not vote for him.
We don't need to go with it. That's, like, what a resistance is about. You fight against something that you want to make an impact with, so.
All right, so here's, and I, you know, at the beginning, day one of this show, we decided that we were going to try to avoid politics in general. and it's really hard to do. And here's my stance, and then I'm just going to shut up, and we're going to get back to some cooler shit.
Mm-hmm.
The president position is a fucking farce. And if you believe for 30 seconds that Obama was able to do anything without the authority of a lot of other people, absolutely.
Babe,
absolutely.
Come in and get just on this fucking microphone.
Just come in and get angry. Please.
But his cabinet is scarier than he is.
I just wish they would.
No,
yeah,
absolutely.
That's what it is. He's like the puppet, you know, that they can blame everything.
All right, wait. Oh, I'm sorry. No, be right here. But all I want to say is I want Mars Attacks to be real. I want the aliens to come down and kill Congress. Kill all of fucking Congress. Anyway, bye. I'm done.
Hold on. Let me finish my point real quick.
My wife, everybody.
Real quick. We spend a lot of time worrying about who's at top. Who is the very foremost person, right? So we have somebody to fucking blame, because that's the thing that we do, is we blame our bullshit on everybody else.
Mm-hmm.
But here's the real facts. 46% of Americans, and I may be fucking that up, did not vote in the last election. So most of you have no fucking right to say.
I think it was more than 40.
It might be more. 46 might be the number that actually came out to vote, and it could be.
Or like wrote in like fucking some random ass name.
Right. The majority didn't vote.
Right.
The second majority voted Hillary.
But beyond that.
Like 12% of people.
Right.
Something ridiculous.
He got like 14,000 votes. Yeah. A dead gorilla. Think about that, guys.
Yeah.
You're not. But, no, that really was actually like a false, I guess. They like proved that it wasn't.
Oh my God, thank goodness.
But still, ooh. Like Ron Paul, though, and Bernie Sanders, that like, you know, people that weren't running.
Right, right. Yeah. Stupid. Like, I'm like, yeah. So that already makes you a douche. Secondly, if you think for 30 seconds that the president makes all of the decisions, then you're also a douche.
Literally makes none.
He makes literally none. He just stands there and takes responsibility for A, the party that he represents, or she, because hopefully we'll get one of those.
Elizabeth
at some point.
Warren.
Right. And takes the brunt of all that shit. You hear people daily, thanks, Obama. Thanks, Obama.
Yeah, Obama's like, thank you.
Obama,
you're welcome.
Obama did literally nothing without approval. literally nothing without approval from Congress, right? Mm-hmm. Like, everything is a matter of checks and balances in this government, and it's all All right, so I'm gonna step back. But we sit around and we're blaming Trump. Trump is obviously a shit face, right? Mm-hmm. Like, that dude sucks. He's openly Cheeto. Fucked up, and he told those of you who support him in fucking public that he basically lied to you to your face to gain your votes.
Yeah, he's like, haha, joke's on you, you fucking ignorant redneck.
And then spit that shit right back during his inaugural
address.
It's like
inbreeding. I'm like, all
right. Spit it right fucking back during his inaugural address. Like,
he quoted Bane, all right?
Yeah.
Like, I saw that.
That's a thing.
Okay, so as someone who is almost an attorney, there is a case called Youngstown. Mm-hmm. And this is what gives, well, it's kind of the precedent for saying or interpreting what the Constitution says that the president has the authority to do.
Okay.
And the president pretty much is not allowed to do anything except foreign policies without congressional approval. And even the foreign stuff, a lot of times he has to have congressional
approval. Absolutely.
And so if people think that, you know, he is allowed to do executive orders, but they have to be pretty much under congressional rule.
Yeah, yeah, even if he vetoes stuff, they can undo. Yeah. I mean, like, just happen, you know, like, yeah.
A lot of people do. I mean, yeah, it's terrifying. And his cabinet fucking scares
me. That's the scary part.
Because, like, you know, they won't off him, so they can have, like, this puppet clown just parading around getting the masses entertained by, you know, his facial expressions. And then they have the real scary people in the background. And, you know, you can't off Trump because then Pence is going
to
be there. And
yeah, that, I was actually talking to one of my friends that Pence was his liability plan.
Like the education woman.
The shit
that
I want.
Oh, my God. Devo fucking grizzly bear statement. Like, are you insane?
Yeah.
Like, the fact that
she's fucking terrifying.
Yeah.
Isn't you she? Ruined I loved Bernie Sanders' questioning of her was like, if your family didn't get $20 million to Trump's campaign, would you be here?
Her face open
the
this.
Entire time, just like this, just
three women just talking about shit that we're passionate.
Yo, dude.
Okay, so
education's important, man.
Yeah.
Our children.
Oh, agreed.
But also going back to Go Away, one of their most recent albums, they did something really special that was near and dear to my heart. I do not have health insurance. I did not fall underneath the I didn't have any of the discounts or anything, and so I couldn't afford it. And so for all of my women's reproductive needs, I go to Planned Parenthood because I can afford it. And Go Away had an album that they released that you got to pick your donation to the album. I believe it started at like $10 or something.
Choose your price.
All proceeds were donated to Planned Parenthood.
Fuck yeah, that's awesome.
And that's one of the reasons why I love Go Away, as well as their music is fucking rad.
Yeah.
But
people need to get the stick out their ass when it comes to Planned
Parenthood. And there is only, there is already
the climate change too.
Yeah, but no, there's already.
Let's just open it. Like, let's just talk about all this.
Let's just do another show.
There's already a precedent that says that Planned Parenthood is not allowed to give any of their federal funding to abortion services. Those are all privately funded, and so anyone who says defund Planned Parenthood because, you know, they just do abortions left and right. No,
they drank way too much of the Kool-Aid.
You are ignorant.
Too much.
You
Fox
drink
News.
The Kool-Aid. You need to stop.
Yeah.
And scene.
Only 3% of the abortions are even.
Three percent of what they do, and they do men's health services too.
Family,
Madison,
like,
you might be getting
you all need to be treated, and you all need to be tested.
Madison's just whatever.
They help all of us when it comes to family or just single men, single women. You know, whatever. You can get help there for an affordable price. So why are you going to get so caught up on something that's privately funded anyway?
Yeah.
Yeah, I, ladies, this
I
is,
wouldn't be able
have no idea. I'm so happy this is happening.
And what's great, though, is a lot of people think that, you know, you go to Planned Parenthood if you have gonorrhea, which are very true.
You can.
But the reasons for going there, oh, I have an STD. Oh, I need an abortion. No, because of Planned Parenthood, I have never needed to get an abortion. I have never needed to have treatment for gonorrhea, syphilis, herpes, anything like that, because they provide birth control, they provide information, and they provide screening, and it's a beautiful thing. And
it really is.
A lot of people don't realize the significance that Planned Parenthood really has, and that is near and dear to my heart.
The media just likes to really pull at people's heartstrings about murder this and murder that.
Oh, they're killing babies.
They try to control people with fear. I mean, Donald Trump's inaugurational speech was literally
fear-based.
There was no hope in it at all.
He's the only president who's never mentioned hope.
Well, that's not true. Recently, though,
that's what I meant.
But I heard someone
progressive society, right?
Is it really progressive though? Look how people voted for Trump.
Right. Yeah. No. Right. Well,
people are fucking stupid in this. I mean, to be honest, it's we do have a lot of progressive people, you know. But absolutely. We also have a lot of people that live in places like Polk County and Ocala and shit like that, where they're I don't want to lump them into a thing, you know. But it's
you can't. I mean, whether you help it or not, there are people there who are
people that are just
way,
the sad truth about our country is just that if you're, if you come from a background with lower anybody income, super lower income, parents that didn't go to college, barely graduated high school, addicts, you know what I mean? So it's you have two alcoholic parents who are super fucking racist. Their dad was in the Klan, whatever. Of course, you're going to grow up and be someone who likes Trump, you know, but. The really awesome thing I have kind of seen start to happen is all these people that are assaulting people. I saw a court hearing recently where a woman was assaulted on a subway. They broke a bottle over her face for wearing, forgot what it was. Yeah. Or even a pin maybe. I can't remember. But she was a bottle was broke over her head and they kicked her down a flight of stairs. And it was a woman and it was a woman who did this though. And instead of being hateful and holding something against this woman, she, in court pretty much said I forgive you. And I hope that you can forgive your,
so strong of a person.
And try not to hate people.
I don't know if I'm that strong.
And it
I would have cut them.
And it showed the woman in there crying. Cause hopefully that makes I feel like anybody that hates someone else for being
a bigger impact
different from them, they just have to meet someone and, form a relationship with them. Cause then they'll realize,
that made friends with all the Klan members, over 200 Klan members.
But no, there was actually, one of the heads of the, CIA, I believe she came out in an interview and said, one of the reasons why a lot of radical terrorist groups hate for the most part is because they don't have that meeting of the minds. And they actually, she said that one day she sat down and spoke to one of the leaders and was why are you doing this? And he's
I don't know.
Have you seen Star Wars? Have you seen Hunger Games? It's about a group of rebels going against a regime that they do not believe in.
Absolutely.
And you guys, your Western culture, you idolize that. Why shouldn't we?
Right.
And then she was like, oh my God, that actually makes sense. Mm-hmm. She wouldn't have known that if she had never sat down and actually had a human-to-human conversation. And that's what needs to happen. And that's what is starting to happen. What a lot of people don't realize, they think, oh, this election, it's brought out the hate and everyone's hating more. No, that was already within.
Yeah.
It's just bringing it to light. And now we can do something about it. Now we can address
everywhere.
It.
Right.
And we can move forward.
We can't really address it if everyone's still hiding under their covers.
Absolutely.
We don't even know.
It's sad, but it's a beautiful thing that needs to happen.
Absolutely.
And I love.
Well, so yeah.
What was your favorite sign that you guys saw?
I've got to come out now. Oh, now that we're talking about Jesus. Things.
Uh-oh. Okay.
I'm into the dark side. I'm sorry.
Oh, and he's back.
Okay, Nick.
Darth Vader fucking rules.
Okay, so perfect segue to, here's the deal. We got real political, and what I want to do right now, obviously this March.
Purge.
Obviously.
No purge. No purging.
Hell no.
All right, so obviously, here's the deal. What I want to do.
All the deaths. all of them.
So
in
what
the streets.
What I prefer to do right now is get back to, we got real political, but I think that today's show is specifically about women and women's rights.
True.
There's no question right now that myself personally, this show, and everybody that's in this room right now is in support of women's rights 110%, no questions asked. And I think that the best way to demonstrate that is to talk to you individually about who it is you are and what it is you do. And how you are just awesome people, because there's no question in my mind that that each one of these women at this table right now is powerful, is strong-minded, strong-willed, and in a lot of ways, just way better people than I am. I could ever be, quite honestly. No, that's true. No, it's true.
It's okay.
No, it's true. And that's okay. And the fact that, here's the deal. And that sounds sappy and shitty, but the truth is real that, like, male or female, there are great people, there are shitty people. And whether or not even the shittiest of people need to be given a chance to be better. And there are those of us, especially the people that I've invited to this room today, who have taken whatever situation they're in and done great things with it. I'm going to start with you, to be honest.
Okay.
Gisselle, I met through Austin Kowal, who, if you have been watching the show from the beginning, you've seen him because we went to his space at Solid and talked to Knowledge Austin when Knowledge dropped his first mixtape. Not first, but definitely his most recent. And so we definitely are going to bring him back on the show at some point. Anyway, I went to an event at Solid and was able to meet Gisselle. And hey. Gisselle and I sat in the background while some other event stuff was going on, and we just started talking. And while we were talking, Gisselle was doodling. Not doodling, because that's not what she does.
It's definitely not anything to describe it.
It's so far beyond doodling. Gisselle is one of the most amazing artists I've met yet. And if you walk into my living room, I've met artists, including myself, because I hang my own shit. Fuck it. But,
it's dope, whatever.
But Gisselle is fire.
Oh.
Fire. And she is finishing up school and doing killer shit right now.
Yep.
So tell us. Okay, so here's the deal. A, first, let people know how they can see some of your work, because if they follow you on Instagram, I think.
Oh, yeah. You can. I haven't been the best at updating my Instagram, but if you want to follow, it is Sketchbook, just Sketchbook, but it has two H's. So Sketchbook with two H's. You'll see all my weird stuff on there from my Sketchbook.
I love it. She calls it weird stuff. And
weird
and,
thingies yeah, there.
It is.
Doodles.
It's a shitty. It's not, though. Like, to say doodled gives it no credit. They're amazing, and the work that she does is fantastic. And at some point, I'm going to beg and plead, and I'm going to ask her to do some shit for me. But
Gisselle, where did you go to school for that? Well, all the stuff in my sketchbook. I mean, I've always been like artistically inclined. Yeah. I've always just like seen shit, and I'm like, I need to put that on paper. And I trained my hand to do it over several years, so it could actually like not look like a bunch of gibberish paper. But I did go to an arts high school because I was, you know, lucky enough to be in Miami, and there's like a whole art district there. And after I graduated from art high school there, I decided to go to and pursue my art education and see if I can go into computer animation. Wasn't really the thing for me because it's more about physics and puppeteering. Yeah, right. So I was like, video games! Hey! Because for me, that's almost like the top art form, because you're in the center of it. You literally have to create and compose an entire world and make it meaningful in a way. Even if it's like Tetris, there is a world of Tetris.
But guys. Yeah. But in order to do that, you also have to be math minded.
In a way, there are definitely kids that are working with me that are way more technical and like would like to be, you know, technical artists, like figuring out what kind of mechanics go when you press this button and the door has to open and then sparks fly, kind of thing. I'm not
like a coder.
I'm not really there.
That's what I went to school for.
I'm not really Taylor. I'm more about making things look pretty. So like, I'll make the crazy, horrible monster at the end that's gonna try and kill you. You know,
which is gonna be dope.
Yes.
Just go to see the Instagram, and then you'll understand what I mean.
Yes.
Dope.
It's awesome.
She's terrifying. Actually, the monster is one of like the most recent.
Your pig is like one of my favorites.
It's like that double organ creature thing coming out of like the little girl's mouth.
Oh, that one was really awesome.
Yeah.
That's this. So fucking good.
I love all the weird, like distended stomachs and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Oh, we should collab on something.
Yes. She has like a huge giant of belly. Because
you've seen my illustrations, right?
Spiders that are supposed to come out and attack you in the video game. Hopefully it'll get approved for thesis, and you know, me and my other lovely teammates will do it. Also girls,
Hell yeah.
Girls doing horror games.
Yes.
Hell
yes. Girls love horror and girls love metal.
Yes. And tattoos.
It's a good show for this. I thought, listen.
Yeah, your pig drawing actually reminded me of like a Pig Destroyer t-shirt I used to have like back in the day.
I love Pig Destroyer. Yes.
That's so thrash good. Grind shit. I don't
still
know.
Have a t-shirt.
Oh, all the nasty
things. I think it's
all
in my blanket.
Things.
I had a t-shirt. Anyway, all right. So
Gisselle is fucking awesome.
Gisselle.
Yeah. Guys, exactly. My ego, guys.
And that's
guys.
Exactly where this Signia is going. Stop. Gisselle fucking rules. Keep doing you. Fantastic. Let's move on to Sam. Sam. You and I have known each other now for like a year and a little bit, probably. Mm-hmm. And so I met Sam through some restaurant shit. We were both doing restaurant shit while trying to set up the stuff that we do now.
Our shit.
Yeah, right. Trying to become us. And so I got to know her. We actually shared the same friends. And
we worked the same places before. And,
right,
weird.
Right. We just kind of like never crossed paths. And so the day, literally the day that I met you,
we were friends.
I was like, I fucking love you. Yeah.
Yeah.
And so Sam and I have been solid since, and we still are 45 minutes apart from each other and talk all the time. Mm-hmm. And like, we just constantly back and forth.
Real friendship.
Yeah. So Sam is not only fucking awesome as a person, she also has been starting a business here in the area. You are from St. Pete.
No, San Francisco.
Oh, sorry. No. Right. Sorry. That's not, I didn't mean to put that. She's right. She knows where she's from.
But I live there.
Right.
Yeah.
But. Right. So she grew up San Francisco, but now currently in St. Pete is what I meant. And doing really awesome stuff. So I've had Night Shift Wax Co. in my house since I've known you, and it's here today. So tell everybody what it is, and then tell us what you brought with you today.
Okay. So my company is pretty much, I make organic soy. Everything is vegan.
Yeah.
It's cruelty-free, but clean burning, all natural candles, and then I also have a skincare line as well.
It smells lovely.
Yeah, it does.
Yes,
okay,
does.
So wait. So
if only we had like Smell-O-Vision or Smell-O.
Yeah, this one is actually podcasts. The pipe tobacco candle.
No, fuck
smells Smell-O-Vision. Really wonderful.
Buy
it's like the
shit.
Grandfather's den, pretty much.
The real answer is you should buy it. And then smell it for yourself.
Yeah, you should buy it, actually.
So
Etsy or my website.
you and I did a little work together. I did some funny stuff with school, and you got to be part of that.
Yeah, with my kitties.
So yeah, it's so true. But we got to talk a little bit about why clean burning and organic is important. And you had personal experience with like other candles that weren't the same as what you're doing. So tell everybody why that is like an important part of what you do.
So, like, I, like, started my company because I was, A, buying way too many candles because I love candles. Mm-hmm. And I was getting really bad migraines, headaches. I was sneezing, you know, just weird stuff like that happening if I bought anything from, like, Target or something. Yeah. And started reading up on it and then realized that half of the – so, like, the industry in general, the organic label, you right. actually only need to be, like – 70% organic. You can have, like, really toxic things still in your products but not – organic.
Way to go, America.
And something like 86% of candles on the market that are sold, you know, to millions in stores right. Are labeled as like, you know, all natural, completely soy, which are actually most of them are like a diluted blend of right. like paraffin and soy wax. So I was just getting, you know, headaches from the paraffin pretty much because right. it literally is like crude oil sludge that they scrape off the top and it burns toxic, obviously. That's why you get a lot of smoking and like a lot of, you know, people say that they're allergic to candles.
Yeah.
That usually is because of that as well. Hmm. But yeah, so I originally started with candles. They kind of took off and everybody like loved the product. And I think it's funny. My candles burn for a really long time. And when I tell people how long, they're like, oh, okay. And then they come back. They're like, dude, no. I'm still burning the candle. Actually, it's been like 2 years. I'm like, what?
It's
how
true.
Does that even?
No, that's real. I've been burning the same two that I've had forever. I feel like a shit because I haven't come back to buy more. But
return on investment.
There you go.
But that's real. Like if you're used to a Glade candle that you buy at Target.
Last 2 hours.
Which mm-hmm. is literally gone in a night.
1 hour.
Right.
Yeah. Well, right. Cool
it's been
too.
Bad.
One like very distracting hour.
Right. Well, I chose to use like only like recycled everything too, like yeah. recycled glass, you know.
I just love
it's
that
BPA
look.
Free and yeah. stuff. So you can actually use it to like store your food, you know, or store whatever. Whenever you you're go. Done with the jar, you can clean it. So it's
multiple
pretty awesome.
Uses.
Yeah.
Why skincare is kind of my... My
okay,
big
this is
thing
new. Yeah, this
now.
Is new.
This
is
oh, yeah.
New.
This right. is, like, my exciting thing. Because I spent, like, so I have a degree in branding. So I kind of got lucky when I started my business because I kind of already knew the whole scheme of like branding, you know. Right. And it was funny, I was actually a fine art major before and decided to not do that. Because everybody was like, what are you going to do with drawing? And I was like, I don't know.
That was the fear, too. That's why I went to video games. I'm like, look at this. I can make money, hopefully.
Oh, without question. It'll always be that way.
Oh, it will. Totally. Yeah. No, but I went to, I actually did like a couple classes like through like an esthetician school to like learn more about like skincare. And just with like my base on like I have like a super passion with animals, like I love animals. I'm super big on fighting against animal cruelty, being
what are you at, 4 cats now in the house?
Yeah, let's not talk about that.
It's okay, I have 3.
Yeah, we live in a 1-bedroom condo though, and I also run a business out of it, so it's really fun.
I currently have a wolf dog.
But yeah. Nick can vouch though, it literally smells fucking amazing in my house.
And you would with the candles.
With the candles.
You wouldn't even tell though. I'm a psychopath. Tell. I like just Yeah, I do my litter box like every day, like every
No, no, that's how you should do it.
Super clean.
But get this, I have currently a wolf dog Malamute with a pit beagle mix, and then our landlord also lives on the property, like kind of in a cabin far into the side there, and they have, I don't know, like 5 or 6 dogs that they brought.
Holy Jesus
Christ. And then there's already like the lab that lives there, so it's a lot of dogs.
Are they free roaming?
You got a pack. It's a pack. Like we live on a fairly large property.
Yeah,
but
it's massive.
It is. But there are areas like sectioned and fenced off, and then our house area also has its own backyard. But like we have 2 dogs in the house, and then like 5 or 6 dogs like right next door, and they just like kind of sometimes like run around, and I'm like, I live in the jungle right now. But you gotta love the animals. I mean,
I'm gonna do a thing real quick, and I hope this doesn't come off wrong. Gentlemen, if you are watching this show and you don't get women's rights and the whole thing, you should watch this because this is a perfect example of how things happen. These ladies are all beautiful, awesome people who do what women do, which is get into conversations and
beat people.
And take it over. Yeah, no, you do it differently.
Be individuals just like everyone.
Yes. But there's definitely is a thing where guys are like, we're just like, this is us. Things are compartmentalized. Women think in a different way. So it's easy for things to go from, let's talk about Sam's skincare thing to how many dogs we have in the yard. That's just something. No. That's
women
not what
rambling.
I'm saying. That's not what I'm saying. And you should not apologize for that at all. But just like you would think that people who look different are different, people of different sexes are different. And that, so I'm just trying to make sure that we tie this whole show into the fact that even though I'm here in full support of everybody who's on this show, male or female, you need to know that people are different, sexes are different, and all of that just needs to be shit you need to fucking get over and just move on with your life. So just watch, see how it goes down, love everybody for being themselves, and continue, and just go. So let's travel back, because I got
skincare.
What I really want.
So this
mom says strong thunderstorms possible till 9 p.m. Don't leave digs.
Thanks, Phyllis.
Yeah,
love you.
All right, so Sam, tell us about
Phyllis
skincare.
Is a strong ass woman too.
She's
I love
a badass.
Her.
Yeah, we'll talk about her soon.
Yeah. So the skincare, I worked on it for like pretty much since I started doing it because I knew I wanted to do skincare. Mm-hmm. Didn't really know as much as I needed to know about it though to be confident in the product. So
sure.
Learn more about it and then. You know, or had to wait to save up to order everything, which was really expensive.
I bet. especially to do it right.
Which is pretty awesome, though, because I will say a lot of people, like, start businesses and, you know, obviously they get loans, they get investors, they do whatever. Yeah. I am really, 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 really proud of myself, though, because I've done it. This is my – October would be my first year. I'm published in 7 different magazines. I was on 18 different blogs. Like, I am sold in, like, 12 different stores, and I literally do it out of my house, and I've never hired anyone to do anything.
Boss bitch.
You go, girl.
All myself.
Boss bitch.
I do everything from, I design the label in Illustrator, I taught myself
HBIC.
Photoshop. I hand label everything, I mix everything, I do everything alone. So it's really exciting. Like, within the exception of, like, you know, my amazing friends that have helped me at markets and stuff like that. But no, it's a really good feeling that people come back and they're actually like, it actually works. Like, my skin is getting better. Or, like, you know, a woman came to me and said that she had adult acne and some hormonal problems and she couldn't find a product forever. And the fact that mine was, you know,
not $300 sold in Sephora that she could afford it. She was like, and it's all pure and like plant-based and just completely vegan.
Cruelty-free.
Like, it really is working, which is pretty amazing. So
your eyeliner.
But this is what I brought you.
Okay, you brought it for me?
Oh. I brought this for you, yeah, because you actually haven't tried it yet, which is pretty exciting.
Because I have
You haven't tried
skin.
Any of the skincare stuff yet.
No, nothing. So. But it's new for me. So.
Yeah. So this is my Indigo Dreams oil. It's like an azulian-rich face oil serum. Azulian literally gets its name just from the obviously blue rich color.
Azul,
you know.
Right.
Yeah.
Spanish for blue.
It's got three different blue oils, four different blue oils in it. So it's got the blue chamomile, blue tansy, blue yarrow, which are all amazing for the skin. They're all antibacterials, antifungals, like antioxidants. They have like rich like omega-3s, fatty acids in your face. I mean, the oil is super, super concentrated. So that's actually a year supply for a little 2-ounce bottle.
Holy
like this.
Shit. All of your products have a ridiculous return on investment.
Yeah
this one, so. When I, you can use that for like, after, so my boyfriend uses it right now, and like he'll shave, you know?
Yeah.
And he just literally drops.
I don't get that. But
like, okay. You know, a couple drops on his skin, and you just rub it in. But it's quickly absorbing, like almost instantly, because the base oils are stuff like jojoba and like argan oil, which are extremely absorbent in the skin. They don't like leave like a layer on the skin. They don't like clog your pores. So right. It's really hydrating, but that one's safe for your lips too. So if you're awesome. A girl and you like wear a lipstick mm-hmm. and it like gets chapped, helps your lips. It's good for cuticles, for your eyebrow, like everything like that.
Just put it everywhere. Guys.
Everywhere.
Yeah, I actually bathe in it. I've been working on a body oil, like a spray. It's like 4-ounce bottle one, and it's like the labels aren't done, but the product's done, and those will be out soon.
So.
I love this woman.
Keep your eyes out on that.
I love this woman.
Those will be out soon, too.
I'm going to be buying
a lot of stuff.
Yeah, I will.
Sam
totally
is one of my favorite
sets.
People, by the way. So just so all of you know, like Sam and
You're
I.
You're one of my favorite people, too.
Yeah, I know. That's why.
You know I am.
Yeah, yeah. We're rad. So this shit, I'm so excited about this. I don't know what to do.
This is kind of cool, though.
Super nice. Okay, so wait. So you're doing cool shit. What else can we expect from Night Shift Wax Co? Because now, now the name almost doesn't, now people are thinking only candles, but now you're doing face stuff. Do you think that you will separate brand, or do you think
No,
you'll...
I talked to, it's funny, I actually like had a conversation with my lawyer about that, mm-hmm. you know, when we were getting the name and everything. And I was like, do you think that makes sense? And he's like, dude, just leave it. He's right. Like, Night Shift is like such a good name.
It is. Mm-hmm.
I mean, like I used to sew, I started another company before this one. And I think, I used to sew like handmade, like 50s inspired lingerie. And Night Shift.
I'd get down on that.
Yeah.
The term
Night Shift. The term Night Shift actually was like something that girls back in the 50s, like women back in the 50s would say when they wanted to do like a slumber party together.
Yeah.
And like look all cute and get like girled up. They were like, they would be like, oh, let's do a Night Shift tonight. You know, it was one of those. So I tried
the
to
stuff
have like.
Stuff that we dream about.
That.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's like when we think of slumber parties, we hope that that's really what's happening.
Yeah. So I already own the rights to the name. So I was kind of like, well. Yeah. Wax company, whatever. And it kind of is just really awesome. That's probably one of the most interesting things I've found with my business is that that's probably the biggest, like, customers will come up and be like, I love your name. Like, I love your branding and your
name.
It's really smart. Yeah. And I'm like, oh, that's awesome. Because, I mean, I love my name too, but it's definitely something that is, I guess, translating with people nice, which is good.
Yeah.
But for me, I'm definitely going to, obviously, I have toned down my candle line. You know, Nick, that I had like 40 or something fragrances.
There was
I
a
needed
lot.
To probably
yeah.
like
there was a lot.
I had to tone it down. So now there's gonna be like a home apothecary collection of that. There's gonna be seasonal collections that come out. There's a masculine like line that's coming out. It's got like I'm doing like a cedar and smoke line for like men's candles. So it's got like a whiskey candle.
Nice.
Which is awesome. Is it
different
it,
whiskey
it's
candle.
Different. Okay.
It's actually better. It doesn't smell as like cheaper whiskey.
Oh,
you know how that one smells
like
less
a more
aged.
Like a rich. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
I got a motor oil candle on there for
that was
shop
in,
owners.
Love it.
That was in
two
the
stroke.
Yep. Yeah.
These,
for shop
these
owners.
Dudes are bike head.
Yeah, because I ride motorcycles as well. So
oh,
I was like,
that's true. Yeah.
I know that.
Oh, yeah.
Did we just become best friends?
Yes. We did. Yeah, so I was like, well, I got to have something like that. And I did Babes Ride Out like a couple years ago. So
I was supposed to do that for my bachelorette party, and I couldn't.
I loved it. Sounds like so much fun. I sold a motor oil candle
there,
and it was pretty awesome.
Fuck.
But
No, so there's going to be a lot of fun stuff. I'm definitely going to do the body things. I am working with someone who I think I'm going to hire. She has a background in hair. That's like what she did. So it'd be really interesting to see, you know, in the future where my company goes. Like maybe we will hair even products? Do like a hairline. Yeah, like or something.
Nice. Good for you.
So, oh, like hair oils.
Guys, keep an eye out if you're at home and you're watching.
Yes, because I use those religiously.
I'm actually going to be going to Nashville tomorrow.
Woo!
Yeah, we're leaving tomorrow. A shop in Nashville got my stuff in there, so I'm going to go and be like checking that out. So that's pretty exciting. So
that's so rad. Okay, so tell everybody at home the best way to find your products.
Nightshiftwaxcompany.com. Or Etsy. Yeah. Just search the Night Shift Wax Co.
And you're also on Instagram.
Yep, Night Shift Wax Co.
Night Shift Wax Co.
Mm-hmm.
You heard it here. Well, hopefully not first. Hopefully you already know. But if you don't know, now you know. Nah, I can't say.
Nah.
All right. So, once again, I've just introduced you to another amazing woman in my life who definitely deserves every bit of promotion that we can possibly give her because she's killing it right now. And the fact that you brought this for me is above and beyond. So I really appreciate you. I love you to
death. Just put it on your head. Your head's going to feel great.
I'll massage it.
So excited. We're just going to cut the show now. But
all right, bye, guys.
I've got one
just
more.
Just all massage.
I've got one more amazing woman in my life right now who is on the show today. No, stop it.
I'll let you do all the talking.
So first of all, I have to let you know that Scott Braun says, Nick, you are in the company of three amazing women. You're absolutely right, Scott Braun. Aww. Without question.
Love you, Scott.
No question.
Thanks.
Obviously, Mad Dog is solid on this show. My homie for life. And when I met Madison, he was without Sarah. Not because he wasn't with her, but because she just wasn't
there. No, I
was
probably at school or something.
Yeah, doing something. Yeah, right. Like bettering yourself.
Yeah.
We were just drinking.
Bettering your education.
We were just out drinking. And the first time.
What's your friendiversary, by the way?
April 23rd.
Yeah.
What's ours?
I got you, bro. Yeah.
We should just have one for ours, too.
We got to figure it out. We'll figure it out.
Yeah.
So the very first time that I invited Madison out beyond. You know, our initial meeting, he brought
your second date.
Our second date was with you. It was a triple date.
I don't know. How I was the third wheel.
You were.
We were at State Street. So I kept making jokes about Madison being my brother.
And I think I let him roll pretty well.
Yeah, it was really funny.
Like, so I got to meet Sarah for the first time, and literally ever since that day, I'm sorry, I don't know the date. We could figure it out though. Sarah and I have been rock solid, almost as tight as me and Madison. And there's no like I'm not picking favorites or anything.
We talk almost every day.
Literally almost every day.
Like I'm taking you to a wedding with me.
That's true. Saturday we're going to a wedding.
That's friendship.
Sarah and I are squad, and we will be for life. And true to everybody at this table, to be honest. But Sarah, I've grown to know in a way that I would never give up. And so here's the deal with Sarah. Sarah is not only one of my best friends ever. Sarah is also one of the smartest women I've ever met and one of the most motivated women I've ever met. Sarah is currently in law school.
Mm-hmm.
Get it, girl.
And not just...
Halfway through.
Not be just like not just like making it, but literally killing it.
Yes.
And you can imagine, because most of us in this world are retarded.
Yeah, what and like takes, our servers.
What it takes to be not just a law student, but to be like a prominent law student. Sarah.
A lot of hard work.
A lot of hard work. Sarah not only has killed hard work, but she has actually sort of redefining it, in my opinion. I'm going to fuck this up, so I'm going to let you do it, to be honest. And it's not Sarah tooting her own horn. It's just because I can't remember all of them. But I need you to... What year are you in?
I am a 2L, which means I'm in my second year.
Second year. Out of four.
Three.
Oh, only three?
Yeah.
See, I already know shit. She's already
halfway
so much
through.
Sarah's the smartest one out of the crew that we roll with, like, on a tight, day-to-day basis.
I was actually not... I was not here... I was in the other room during the first half of this pod because I had to video into a mandatory meeting for my Phi Delta Phi Legal Honor Society. I was doing that.
I also, today, this morning I did some work for the Western Michigan University Cooley Law School Law Journal, which I am the marketing editor for.
Hell yeah, girl.
Get it.
I'm watching Madison right now.
I'm also like, this week.
He's quietly like, gloating. No, you
this week I am so expecting I'm expecting my remaining two grades to come out from last term's finals. And I I already have two.
Guaranteed.
Nice. I am highly anticipating one of my grades for the second most difficult course offered at my law school, which I strongly believe that I booked, which is the terminology you use when you get the highest grade in the class.
Yes.
I get to talk about my wife.
Wait. Oh, yeah.
I get to talk about my wife. Cool. Sara works so fucking hard at law school. She literally lives killing in her it. Office.
Sara,
she school. Spends so much time at school. She literally goes to school 5 or 6 days a week. She goes up to Tampa and drives back to Sarasota every day.
Every day. That's a 40 to an hour commute, depending
my
on the day.
My poor car gets 500 miles per week put on it because of my commute.
She's the most dedicated woman that I've ever met besides my mother. Dedicated, passionate about what she does, sweet, endearing, strong. She's been through a fucking lot in her life. And you know what? She almost did not go to law school. And we had the conversation. And I was like, you have to go to law school. It's what you were meant to do. And that's one thing that we have done in our relationship is we've backed each other 100% whatever we did.
Call each other out on our bullshit.
And call each other out on our bullshit. But when she wasn't going to go to law school, I told her, no, there's no fucking way that you're not going to law school. And then when I was having my career like craziness going on, she was like, you have to get out of there. You got to do what's best for you. Mm-hmm. So she's always been my rock and everything, and I fucking love her more than anything. And we got to get married, and but seriously, I don't know anybody that has persevered and is just stoked on life and just grabs life by the balls so hard.
This pussy grabs back.
Yeah, balls. Nasty woman. Nasty woman. Anyways.
I'm such a nasty woman.
All the best women are.
Shit. You've seen the fucking sign, my neck, my back, my pussy grabs back. I was like, yes. Someone was changing that yesterday, and I was like, all right, Kaya.
What was
I see you, bitch. I didn't mean to take over a microphone, but I needed to speak voice because that. I love her more than anything. So aww, I will awesome. Do anything
absolutely.
For you.
Absolutely. And we need to just, you know, obviously you Sara has been with us on this pod from the beginning. So she gets extra love from us because so not only is she somebody that hopefully if you're watching, you've grown to know and love, but
I just noticed your shirt. That's fucking awesome. I'm sorry.
I don't know if I'm going to show it on air, but okay, I'm
right.
here.
There's a maybe. Okay, got it. All right. So Oh, it's so. She's showing us a picture that says
Trump likes
Nickelback.
Everybody, just letting you fucking
hilarious.
Know. Okay?
I saw.
Remember
one that says
shit.
Number one
fan.
Vote for him.
Yeah, Trump smokes mids. Fuck him.
Oh, I saw that shit. So
no,
good.
I saw one that says Trump loves Three Doors Down, and I was like, okay, that's fucking hilarious.
The one I just showed her was
the fact that they were trending. I was like, all right.
Super callous, fascist, racist, extra braggadocious. The sound of him is actually quite atrocious.
Oh, damn.
That brilliant. One I was just like, damn.
I just saw one that was like, your hair looks like shit, and I thought that was really funny.
And gentlemen, that is female brilliance at its best. Listen, here's the
simple
deal.
Simple to the point.
Here's the deal.
To the point.
Scott Braun says, in all caps, fuck you, Mad Dog. You almost made me cry with that gross, cute story. So here's the deal. Bottom line is that I've invited three amazing women who are a great representation of what this planet has to offer. And again, all of us in this room are just people. We're just people trying to make it, do our thing. And if you don't give everybody the opportunity to be people without any stereotypes, and I am not free from those. I wish I was, but I'm not. there are things that happen to us in this world that are fucking crazy, and everybody's life is equally just fucked up and kind of crazy. But what we hope is that we meet people in our lives who affect us in positive and awesome ways. And what I've got at this table right now is three people who I would love for the rest of my life. Mm-hmm. And you need to know that if you are doing anything beyond what I'm doing right now, I'm fucking coming for you. I'm coming for you, and I don't fucking care what the repercussions are.
Yeah.
You need to know that everybody needs to be treated with respect. All of these people are fantastic human beings and deserve every last ounce of your respect. And if you don't, I'm coming for you. Everybody I tell to come for you is
We're coming for you.
The legal opinions expressed by the host do not reflect the opinions expressed by the guests.
No. This is me talking to the listeners.
This is just me.
But you have to know that just from the people at this table, you're in fucking trouble.
Women are fucking awesome.
Amazing.
They really are.
Amazing.
So are gay and trans and black people.
Yes.
Everyone. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Muslims, Hispanics.
Yep.
Anybody.
Literally
except
everybody.
Except bigoted assholes.
Yeah. Except racist pieces of shit.
Mm.
If who deny climate change.
If you're shitty, you're going
to...
Listen to Nickelback.
Yeah.
Science. They are allowed to think that.
Find your little groups.
Doesn't make they're not pieces of shit.
Find your little groups and see what happens.
Hashtag garbage people.
Every time that people who hate find their groups, we find a way to pin you down and figure out who you are. And now that we're in the information age, you're in trouble. Mm-hmm. Here's the answer to today's story, is that we just made the longest show that we've ever made.
Oh,
really?
Yeah.
Yeah, guys.
Wow.
We have now gone to
women talk
approximately.
A lot.
No.
I like to poke fun at myself.
We talk about important shit.
Yes, we do.
Here's the deal.
We do.
I do talk a shit ton, though.
Today
we're breaking that goddamn glass ceiling.
Today we touched on the most important topic that has happened on the show to date. And if you have any problems with that, come see me. Here's the answer. I love everybody in this room. I will openly love everybody who ever comes into my life until you fuck it up.
Just love one another.
And that's
being so shitty.
And that's the way it should be. And it has nothing to do. It has nothing to do with color, gender, sexual orientation, or anything beyond. It has everything to do with individuality. And if you don't like somebody because of something, that's going to happen. What you can't do is generalize and create these weird stereotypes that are fucking up our society.
Normalize the resistance.
Yeah.
See, all of these women are smarter than me. Here's the deal, guys. We're going to wrap it up today, but you just got introduced to three of my favorite people. And I'm so blessed to have all of you on this show. And I hope that we can bring you back individually.
Love you, Nick.
I love you back. I hope that individually I can bring you back as guests on this show in order to do other things, because we want to promote you in everything that you're doing. When you graduate, we're gonna have a fucking... this show is gonna go nuts.
You're gonna live pod my graduation.
I'll do some trippy art, and we'll have all the candles.
I'll just make a candle that is like sculpted into Sara's figure, and we can burn it when she like lights.
Yes.
See what I mean? See what they just did? They immediately just made my party way bigger. And that's... listen, guys. Here's the deal.
That's why you need women.
Here's the deal. Whether we want to admit it or not, the only reason that women are... that all of these women came out yesterday for equal rights is because of us. There's nobody else to oppose but males. When it comes to women's rights, the only opposition is men's rights. And so it is the male problem. It is a problem that is so ingrained in us.
And that is fucking made from our forefounders. Like,
right?
They
that shit. It's history. It's history without question.
Read the Lysistrata.
It's time. Yeah. It's time to stop. You're not losing anything in your masculinity when you accept the fact that there are women out there who are powerful. There are women out there who are strong and strong-minded and have things to say, and they deserve respect. And that is the bottom line of today's show. We hit 2 hours and 15 minutes today because that is what I need to prove to you today. We went 45 minutes longer than I expected to, because that is what we're here for today. I don't know a really good way to express.
I have a really good ending for the show.
Oh, there it is.
I don't know if any of you have heard of Snoop Dogg before.
Oh, yes.
He's I've not heard that big, no.
Yeah. Snoop.
He was on Real World, right?
He's really good friends.
Is that like really short guy, right?
Brother, yeah, short, sister, one maybe? Kind of
chubby.
He's super short. He's into jazz, I think.
Have you seen the Snoop Dogg video I posted on my wall?
No.
Go on it right now and just play that shit for us. It's fucking hilarious.
Wait, it's on your Facebook wall?
Yes.
Hold on. It's gonna take a second.
No, here I'm there.
Facebook. You got it? Yeah.
Let's pull it up.
Just play it. Yeah. Hold so, because oh, it took me a second.
Your internet's being really awesome.
Yeah. It's because we're all on it and I'm feeding a show. All right, wait.
You're like, stop hating.
Sam Cipriani, go boom.
It should Sam still be Cipriani, better. It's 2017. Okay, here.
Since we know how you really feel, it's how we feel. Fuck Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump.
How you gonna have yeah, your... Yeah, well, how you gonna have your wife get at Michelle Obama, nigga? Fuck you, nigga. Now I'm on a mission, too. Yeah, nigga. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. We ain't bone for your punk ass. I'll get you a new hairdo, you bitch ass nigga.
There we go. So, in the words of Snoop Dogg, fuck Donald Trump.
Ladies and gentlemen,
get yourself a new hairdo.
Yeah.
Listen,
please.
We ain't gonna hate on Michelle Obama.
Right. We appreciate you sticking out 2 hours plus on today's show. Those of you who did and stayed out through the entire show, you recognized that this was an important show for us. I am super proud to have all of these people on the show. These guys are loving each other over here. Over here, I've got such power, such grace, such beauty. All of these people deserve the utmost respect. Do me a favor real quick. Let's just go back around the table real fast. Let people know how they can find you.
You can find me on Instagram at Sketchbook, and that's Sketchbook with 2 H's.
Perfect. Sam?
You can find my company at Night Shift Wax Co. Via Etsy, Instagram, and the company's website, nightshiftwaxcompany.com.
Perfect. Sarah, do you care to be followed?
Sarah is _SarahMarin.
Oh.
Yeah.
Who has a husband now who's jumping in for her?
Yeah.
Mansplaining.
It's my producer. It's her manager.
I'm the owner.
So good. Folks, go make sure you follow all of these women. They're doing fantastic things, and we are super proud to have them on the show. But you know what I'm going to do right now is end the show and plug myself real quick. So the next time you're on YouTube, make sure you subscribe to me at Ghost Riot Radio. Be sure to leave me a comment in the space below and hit that thumbs up button if you like this video. Really honestly, make sure that you follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/Ghost Riot Radio. And you can also follow me at Ghost Riot Media on Facebook as well. On Twitter, you can follow me at Ghost Riot Media. But now on Instagram, you can follow me at Ghost Riot Radio. Do me a favor. Subscribe to us as a podcast on iTunes, SoundCloud, Stitcher, and TuneIn Radio. And make sure you check out GhostRiotRadio.com. One more time, I want to thank Nomadic for letting us rock out to their tracks today. If you want to check them out, make sure you check out Nomadic if you're in need of some serious metal in your life, because who doesn't need that in your life? And if you don't, get into it, because it's a really good idea. Go check them out on Facebook. You can check them out on Spotify. Please go check out their Spotify. And if you're checking out this final track, you can find it on their available YouTube channel. And the song that we're going to play, last but not least, is called Monster. Oh, excuse me, The Monster. Oh, I just turned you way up for some reason, because I know you're going to say something. As always, I'm Nick Noble. Thank you for joining us for episode 14. We'll see you next Sunday for another episode of Ghost Riot Radio. And please, don't forget, make your presence known. Spread some love to literally everybody. And we'll talk to you soon.
I'm a nasty woman.
Peace. So good.